Hi, it's time for another episode of The Thought Project, just so you know. And today we're starting out with Bill Withers' Lovely Day, which I wouldn't really dance that much to. We probably won't listen to it as long.
When I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day. Lovely day, 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 lovely day. When the day that lies ahead of me.
And that is enough for now. It's not much of a dance song, so I don't feel like there's a whole need to really go through a longer dance. Like, I'm certainly not going to dance the whole song today, as much fun as the song is. And I hope you're all doing well. Today's show is going to be on some interesting economics and crime, and then also we're going to talk about the situation with China and their economics, and how it affects the U.S. As I detailed in previous episodes, it actually isn't really a problem for the U.S. as much as that it just affects world geopolitics. Anyways, we'll start with literally Janet Yellen. So I thought her trip would be Tuesday, but apparently by what the US calendar is going to be or how things have fallen out officially, she's going to be in China on Thursday through Sunday this week on US time. As you know, when somebody's in a different part of the world, it can literally be a different day where they're at, or it's just the logistics are kind of different. So anyways, and I'm just going through all this material. So the one thing you need to note right now is that the Chinese yuan is only at 0.14 compared to 1.00 of the US dollar, which means it's only worth 14 cents of the US dollar. Now, noting all of that, right now the Russian ruble is only worth 0.011 to the US dollar. And then let's look at the other big thing, which is for BRIC conference and their numbers, because their numbers are a little bit different as far as Brazil and India go. The Brazilian real is at 0.20 cents of the US dollar today, and the Indian rupee is only at 0.012 of the United States dollar. So that's their economic conference. And they are talking about establishing their own currency, but their strongest, I mean, this looks like their strongest currency is Brazil right now, the Brazilian dollar. Not going to help too much. And this is in comparison to the world at large, where you consider that the English are valued at, I think they're at the pound is at like 1.27 today, 1.25. So those currencies are probably stronger. Anyways, but the Chinese, wealthy Chinese citizenship at this point are now just giving up on the country, frankly. They're trying to get their kids out if they have money. They're paying people to take their kids and move them out of the country. And frankly, are trying to buy what's called insurance and investments through the Hong Kong insurance, which is actually a financial pipeline to purchasing stocks and property, since they no longer think that what they have in China is going to be worth anything. And I say all this because with our stock markets down, and it's all individual decisions, it's not like one group that's responsible. It's literally just this is what's happened, and this is how the Chinese citizenship and investors are reacting. But you need to know who Hong Kong Insurance is, because that's actually a main investing group and investing in Hong Kong and Macau wealth products. That's Macau. Okay, or the Macau, however you want to say it. But in Asia, they say macaw. So, and the US dollar is worth 2.8% of deposit, even using in Chinese investments, while the yuan will only get you 1.65% return, and noting the difference in value. So, I think at this point, for a lot of the Chinese, it's trying to not putting all their eggs in one basket. What does that mean for everybody else? Well, it means there's a whole lot going on with Asian markets, because there's a big rush to get out of anything that's involved with China, if you're intelligent. So, for us in the US, it's just an opportunity. I mean, we've suffered for a long time catering to the Chinese. Both major political parties agree that they've become increasingly hostile, and they have, and they're staying hostile. Xi Jinping has now taken credit for telling Vladimir Putin to not use nukes in Ukraine and is asking for credit for it. And if that means he actually wants money for it, then I think pretty much everyone would say, get a grip, get real. The way he's going to give you money for that. Especially not when they're doing it at this point when they think it would be financially expedient. So, I'm going to move on to more fun stuff. And we do need to talk about a few other things. So, right now there's a case down in Louisiana that has to do with freedom of speech issues and tech because there's been a huge issue with some of the tech companies actually working with government officials in some cases to suppress people's freedom of speech, which is incorrect. And at the same time, not going after actual criminals and not using the tools at their disposal through tech products to actually catch predators. The reverse actually needs to be true, which is that freedom of speech is protected and that predators are actually caught, right? They have to actually be caught using it. It can't be used to just oppress anybody who says, please don't steal from me, and I'd rather not be raped. There's been kind of a problem with that, right? That's why the FBI is in trouble. So, as far as all of this goes, the main point is that the First Amendment for now is being supported. And there's going to be, like, there's a temporary injunction right now, a preliminary injunction is what it's called. There's still going to have to be an actual court case and a ruling. But how this case goes in Louisiana is actually fairly important for First Amendment rights in the U.S. because that's what's been at stake. It's been that people like myself and other people who've been victims and been extorted from have been told to shut up. And just be stolen from. And even at the expense through tech platforms. While criminals, and especially the Russian mafia, have pulled ahead. And people related to Chinese business interests tied into the use of the Russian mafia. So I think you can see how this all kind of plays together and what the issue is. Now, I'm gonna explain something to you today. I'm gonna teach you something. I'm gonna give you something. And I want you to do me a favor if you use it. You have to subscribe to the show on YouTube. And you have to talk to other people about subscribing to the show. Because I need subscribers. That's part of how I'm building the show. So you need to do that. You actually need to do that. I'm gonna give it to you, but you gotta give me something back, okay? So, anyways, now you subscribe at Deborah KC on YouTube. As far as I'm gonna show you something here. I'm gonna tell you something. I'm not gonna show you things. By the way, stay away from crazy people that want to talk about how showing you things. If they say they can't tell you, and they're like, "No, I can only show you," and they act weird, be like, "No. If you can't tell me, I don't want to know. I don't want to see it. I don't want you to show me anything, because I guarantee you the next thing they do is pull their pants down or something else weird." So you learn that too. Now, here's the thing. You're probably wondering, looking back, how do these shell groups, shell organizations of Hollywood set up performers to become supposedly famous big time performers? Why are they considered to be so important? And I'm just going to sit down for a minute while I talk to you about this because it's not rocket science. It's real easy, honey. People buy their own PR, they purchase PR. And they end up, you can buy a firm, you can have your own firm, you can hire a firm. You can do it yourself. And a lot of it is budget and technicalities. So you can buy web traffic, honey, and you can buy optimization for your website, and you can buy all that stuff if you don't know how to do it yourself. Now, I have a certification in PR, and I had a website that had 500, 600,000 hits, like views a month. People love my stuff. My problem is that I was actually being attacked by hackers who were part of the terrorist organization that was extorting work from me, and they were actually refusing to let me get
they were putting up paywalls and getting themselves paid, and I kept having to take them down, and they were blocking me on ads and everything else online. This is what's affected modern newspapers and caused so many of the newspapers to be only run by people who are Russian, which is why so much they use in the U.S. is fake, because it's from people who have deals with Russian hackers and mafia. That's why you can't trust the mainstream media. By and large, the people you see that are supposed to be Hollywood big-time quote-unquote stars are not big stars, because they're actually people who purchased all of it, and preferably through the venues and markets that are working with the Russian mafia in the U.S. This is where the term fake news came from. Donald Trump is not the first person to ever said it. Anybody who studied mass media and communications in the U.S. and hacking issues is aware of it. It's a real problem. It's a real problem. Because it funds drugs. And it funds murder. And it funds the theft of children from their families. Okay? So that's why I'm telling you some of this stuff. I'm trying to teach you. Now, here's what's really important to understand. So with me, I have my voice taken, likeness. I was forced to give up acting tips, scripts, plots for films, TV, all of it. The U.S. government put a stop to all that, which is great, right? It's really important. It's really, really important and great. Now, so you're seeing already the industry is starting to have some problems, right? They're not really able to keep up, so to speak. And it's the same thing, unfortunately, when you look at the use of signet systems as well to control performers. Because the two major agencies I know of in Hollywood, and by the way, most of the whole Hollywood establishment that actually matters has said that Hollywood is basically done because of these practices and how disgusting it's become with so much of the Russian mafia trying to take over. But I tend to use radio signals to try to control people and to give signals to their mafia. If you're not in it, it's not going to work, because you're not going to have the neurological type of brain or anything else to understand them, but you're not going to interpret them. But also, you're probably going to get hurt. So when you look at some of these so-called movements like Me Too movement, these women who've been raped and abused and these bizarre crimes, it's all being done with the use of signet systems. And that's something the Russians are really bad about. Remember I said their military isn't very good. Their main thing is the hacking and the technology stuff. And that is the one thing they do, which is the signet system. So remember, the Chinese also have a fairly strong system for that too. So, say for example, you take, I don't know, any number of these performers that lip sync. I'm going to do the pop singers because that's an easy example, pop singers. But they get up there, they sing, and it's all lip sync, digital technology, right? They got to hold their mic like this. They're like making love to the microphone because they're not singing. It's a playback device, okay? Pretend it's a microphone, it's playing back the information. And it's playing back the sound, okay? So it looks like they're singing, they're not. And the dancing is bad, and the performances are bad, and you think, how is this person featured at Walmart or anywhere else? Well, because of money. Because they're using money to fund all of it. And they're not very good at performing. And who is Hollywood anyways when there's so many performers all over the country, performing, who are good and talented? And why do we have articles pretending that these people actually matter still, when there's so many other performers all over the country that are better and actually can dance and actually can sing and actually write their own material? Why are we pretending that these ones are actually any good? We're not. It's what's happening. It's what's going on. And I just explained the method to that and how it comes about. So when you look at all this material, you then start to think of bizarre legal agreements. Like, for example, Taylor Swift has a serious issue with having stolen a lot of material, and she was part of the network with J-Lo, just KGB, FSB. You can believe me or not, I really don't care. But the reality is, I know it's true because I lived through all this stuff. And she recently sold all of her masters to Scooter Braun. I'm still trying to figure out who convinced Scooter Braun to buy all this stuff, because he bought a bunch of other performers who were also part of the Russian Albanian mafia, and I don't know what he's doing, because he's buying stuff that's fake. Like, it's like he's buying truckloads of fake Prada purses and nobody knows why. And the only thing anybody could think of, I would assume, is to destroy the material. It certainly isn't to get people like me paid who were never paid for the work. It certainly isn't about taking care of any of the victims. Certainly isn't about good business practices. It's not even a good investment. Got to be a favor. Got to be a way to destroy evidence. That's all I can think of. But he's also somebody that's probably going to end up being a witness. And if you think things aren't weird, oh, it's weird. It's going to get real weird. Because at this rate, you're coming pretty close to Scooter Braun having to go in and testify in court to say that Hunter Biden did it in the living room with the candlestick. This is like a reference to Clue the game. So when you look at the entire situation, you need to also recognize, because I'm going to come back to Biden, Trump, all this stuff that's going on in Hollywood, DC, the hearings, like the back and forth is nuts. You know, a judge recently ruled that Donald Trump would not be called in to do a deposition in the lawsuit that Peter Strokes has against the FBI for being fired. And I can't even say Peter's name. It's, the last name is spelled S-T-R-Z-O-K. So he's, you know, been let go of, and now he wants to bring Donald Trump into a deposition, throw a big fit about how he's wrongfully terminated when his behavior was super unprofessional. And he was super, super rude in court. Super, super rude in Congress. And I'm not saying this in defense of anybody, but I'm just saying that's the reality. Guy's really sketchy. So now that I explain all this to you, you can start to understand, knowing this, the how many people have been ripped off in the U.S., knowing how much of the industry, as far as the entertainment industry goes, we've talked about movies and the bizarre placement of images and the weird plot lines, and, you know, and I've finally just told some of you, you know, you may just want to skip some of these movies because, or skip the movies, really, because you don't want to be, do you really want to see a movie that was just made for China? No, you don't. So, I mean, and you can do any little thing you want, anything at all. This is really just information for you. But I just want you to think about this, because I'd hate to see you spend money in a movie and come home unhappy. And I just want you to know what could be going into your own mind, what you want out of life, right? So, because one reason I was able to get out of it, because I had a hard time getting the extortion because of the greed involved. Other people were getting paid off. The government, other people should have cared more, just didn't. But one argument I was able to make was the fact that it was clearly funding terrorism and drugs and all the weird ideas they were trying to put into people's heads, right? And the fact that some people even felt for religious purposes that some of these pop singers were just demons or pretending to be demons, and they really didn't appreciate their behavior. And that was something that even people who would be considered leftists agreed with. So, you know, the idea of a woman going out on stage and masturbating in public and just being disgusting and weird and beating people up and raping women all over the place and hurting kids and talking foul and running off with her husband that she's had set up for her by the Russian government just really offends people. You know, the theft of an artist's work. I had a lot of work stolen, guys. Too much. And a lot of people involved said there was too much stolen from me. You went too far, darlings. So, and you have to remember that a lot of the American public knows this. They know that the Hollywood isn't really the real performers or the only ones. They know they're being fed trash. They know they're being presented with paid for and bought material that was funded with drugs. Now, for the Russian government and this bizarre relationship with China, it's not real. It's not real, honey. So here's the thing. Got a lot of performers being attacked lately. And what carries me through all of this is knowing that it had nothing to do with me or anyone else. This is just what's happening. But they're turning on each other more. And I think also audiences are just turning on them because they're continuing to try to perform when they're really not welcome to anymore. And I think the big thing about it is that when you consider somebody on stage doing a fake performance that is so mentally ill that they don't see how that's offensive, that's something you have to really be concerned about. And I don't know what else you could do except to take them off the stage. But their managers are psychopaths. They're obviously psychopaths. Totally out of touch with reality. They're not going to get off the stage. So they're just going to keep getting attacked. And they've all been singled out and identified for what they are, so it's not going to get better, right? Not going to change. And the American people are savvy to it all now. So the attacks are just going to get worse. worked in for security for a year when I was in Charlottesville. I never saw any of the performers get attacked. Nobody ever threw anything at them. Not to be mean. Not to hurt them. You know, in the old days of vaudeville, though, when they had problems with people that were tied to crime trying to perform on stage and trying to run their business in the audience, what they used to do is they get out these long, long sticks, wooden sticks, and they had a hook on the end. This is a pinwheel, but it had a hook on the end. And they would actually grab it by the person's neck and pull them off the stage. And I think if a lot of these performers don't get it together and realize that they're not really good performers, they're not real, and we know what they're really doing, and just get off the stage, a lot of them are probably just going to get more seriously hurt. That's going to be a whole lot worse. And I don't think there's any amount of security that's going to be able to help. Because people are fed up and they're tired of it. They just want them to go away. Just go away, go away, go away. We are done. Now, I need to address something else. Madonna got out of the hospital. She had sepsis. Apparently, they'd had to revive her with Narcan. I don't think Narcan is normally used in most situations, but it's definitely used with drug overdoses and with sepsis. So when there's a bizarre situation where a person has lost consciousness, but it's generally used with drug overdoses. The sepsis use is just an emergency situation. It's certainly possible. It's possible, but don't think Madonna is actually one of them. In all the years that I was extorted from, she was one person that I never provided anything to, never had to. And there were too many people that hated her. Cersei hated her. Cersei and Wilhelm were part of the reason I had so much extorted from me, and they hated Madonna. Not because she got on stage and made naughty moves and danced around and talked about expressing herself and being a man and working hard, but because she was somebody who was known for paying people for their work. Yeah, she wasn't going to participate in their Now, saying all this, I need to address a really bizarre criminal event that happened recently, which is that Victor Wembanyama of the NBA's head of security slapped Britney Spears at Catch Restaurant in the Aria Hotel in Las Vegas. His name is Damian Smith. And she was with Sam Asghari at the time, and she had a whole bunch, like 20 people with her. So she had an entire entourage. And she walked up behind Wembanyama and tapped him on the shoulder and asked him for an autograph. And his head of security promptly turned around and hit her in the face. She then said, very nicely, got away from him and reported to police. Now, here's the issue. The head of security claimed he didn't know her. That's why he hit her. So anytime you don't know somebody, you just hit them? What if she had been dangerous? Doesn't make sense. Here's the other problem. They saw her coming. So he waited all the way until she came across the room and then tapped him on the shoulder and then hit her? Kind of sounds like a setup. Kind of sounds like it was done on purpose. Yeah, I think it was. I think there's an issue there where Brittany is one of those people that concerns me because she gets into so much trouble as far as her inability always to interpret information. And she was one of these performers who started out young and she was on a Signet system. I don't think anyone's ever fixed it, and she's still in the same network with those two different agencies. They've got it buried, but she's still working with one that uses those. I think that was a setup to get her hit. I do. Because criminals will break into those as well and get people beat up and injured. So it's just kind of important to know. Anyways. I think, guys, we're coming all the way back around to this, you know, like Shania Twain fell the other night. That could have been from aging and dancing, but it also could have been a hit. It could have been a hit in the leg. That can happen during performances. So she was sabotaged. No, we're back to the days of wondering about lines around Vietnam and what Japan's doing. Anyways. But the point about all of it is that if you ever said, why couldn't I be a big star or anything? Well, the reality, honey, is if you got the money to pay for it all, and the time to work on it, you can. My situation was that my money for school to go to medical school was taken from me, and I wasn't allowed to go to nursing school either because these idiots are completely out of control. And it's very, very real. And there's no reason for me to be struggling or having any of these issues today. So that's what's going on. And I just want to make sure people really understand all of that, you know, going through this series, and that they understand that there's a larger issue with crime, you know, rape, murder, theft of children, drugs related to Russian mafia and extortion And at the center of it is some of these really bizarre performers that just are completely spoiled children that are just lip-syncing on stage and terrible. And there are too many people involved who didn't even care if they're bad because they're just using it to run drugs. And that's all it's really about. So, anyways, I hope you're enjoying your Friday. I'm going to take you out with a version of my version of Don't Stop Believing by... Or, well, it was originally performed by Germany. I always say originally performed by because I don't know how many of these people bought a song from somebody else or how who worked on it or who really owned it. So I just say originally performed by. But that's all the good stuff. And from here on out, I'm probably going to start performing, actually, when I sing closer up. So you can, because the microphone on the phone actually picks up the sound better. So here we go. Seemed impossible. Haha, no, I'm just kidding. Okay. Just a small town girl living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. A singer in a smoky room, a smell of wine and cheap perfume, or a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on and on. Strangers waiting up and down the boulevard, shadows searching in the night. Streetlight people living just a fine emotion, hiding somewhere in the night, working hard to get my fill. Everybody wants a thrill, paying anything to roll the dice for just one more time. Some will win, some will lose. Some are born to sing the blues. Oh, the movie never ends. It goes on and on and on and on. Stranger waiting up and down the boulevard, their shadows searching in the night. Streetlight people living just to find emotion, hiding somewhere in the night. Stop believing, hold on to the feeling.
And that is the end of the show for today. So I hope you all have enjoyed everything I put together. There's been more than enough information. And, you know, it's supposed to be a good time. So I hope you enjoy your weekend. Enjoy the rest of your Friday. Thanks.